السلام عليكم.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
تقاربوا بارك الله فيكم. get closer please, move forward please. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره. أعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Have the taqwa of Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. Allah the Almighty is saying in the Quran, فَقْصُصُ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Narrate the stories of Muhammad to them so they may reflect. There is a purpose behind stories in Quran. This is not a stories for a bedtime to put a child to go to sleep. This is not a fake stories. It is a reality. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to narrate, to say, to relate the story to his ummah. The matter if it's in the Quran or in the authentic hadith. For what purpose? لعلهم يتفكرون, that they may reflect, they may think, they may learn a lesson. And today, inshallah, I would like to share a story with you, which is a real story. This story, you may see it in this book, Once Upon a Time, or you may look in Riyad al-Salihin, Garden of the Righteousness. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying in the hadith, which is a collection of Imam al-Bukhari as well as Imam Muslim, reported by Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, أنه سمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن ثلاثة من بني إسرائيل أبرص وأقرع وأعمى أراد الله أن يبتليهم فبعث إليهم ملكا فأتى الأبرص فقال أي شيء أحب إليك؟ قال لون حسن والجلد حسن ويذهب عني الذي قذرني الناس فمسحه فذهب عنه قذره وأعطي لونا حسنا. قال فأي المال أحب إليك؟ قال الإبل أو قال البقر, شك الراوي. فأعطي ناقة عشراء فقال بارك الله لك فيها. فأتى الأقرع أي شيء أحب إليك؟ قال شعر حسن ويذهب عني هذا الذي قذرني الناس, فمسحه فذهب عنه وأعطي شعرا حسنا. قال فأي المال أحب إليك؟ قال البقر, فأعطي بقرة حاملا وقال بارك الله لك فيها. فأتى الأعمى فقال أي شيء أحب إليك؟ قال أن يرد الله علي بصري فأبصر الناس, فمسحه فرد الله عليه بصره. قال فأي المال أحب إليك؟ قال الغنم, فأعطي شاة والدا فأنتج هذان وولد هذا, فكان لهذا واد من الإبل ولهذا واد من البقر ولهذا واد من الغنم. ثم أنه أي الملك أتى الأبرص في صورته وهيئته فقال رجل مسكين قد انقطعت به الحبال في سفري, فلا بلغ لي اليوم إلا بالله ثم بك. أسألك بالذي أعطاك اللون الحسن والجلد الحسن والمال بعيرا أتبلغ به في سفري. فقال الحقوق كثيرة. فقال كأني أعرفك, ألم تكن أبرص يقذرك الناس فقيرا فأعطاك الله؟ فقال إنما ورثت هذا المال كابرا عن كابر, إن كنت كاذبا فسيرك الله إلى ما كنت. وأتى الأقرع في صورته وهيئته فقال له مثل ما قال لهذا, ورد عليه مثل ما رد هذا، فقال: إن كنت كاذبا فسيرك الله إلى ما كنت. وأتى الأعمى في صورته وهيئته فقال له: رجل مسكين وابن سبيل انقطعت به الحبال في سفري، انقطعت به الحبال في سفري، فلا بلاغ لي اليوم إلا بالله ثم بك، أسألك بالذي رد عليك بصرك شاة أتبلغ بها في سفري. فقال: قد كنت أعمى فرد الله علي بصري، فخذ ما شئت ودع ما شئت، فوالله ما أجحدك اليوم شيء أخذته لله عز وجل. فقال: أمسك عليك مالك، أمسك مالك، فإنما ابتليتم، فقد رضي الله عنك وسخط على صاحبيه، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم narrating us about three people from the children of Israel. This is the previous nation before us. And many things happened between them and their prophet or their prophets. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrate about what happened and recorded some of it in the Quran and some in the authentic hadith. This is ra'fah and rahmah and mercy of Allah with this ummah, so they can learn from the mistakes and take heed from the example of the previous nation. The class on the lesson is repeated again and again. And as we stated in the first khutbah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقْصُصُ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Why the story? So we can think, we can reflect, we can learn a lesson. So three persons from the children of Israel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attend to test them, check them out, see their iman, see their obedience to Allah. Because everything that you have, if it's life, if it's death, if it's property, if it's knowledge, if it's the children, being single, married, you're homeless, or you have a house, everything is nothing but a test. You may did not hear the words, but you look to it, and you have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even about our children and our property, He told us, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةً. Indeed, your property and your children are a test for you. The three of Bani Israel, three persons, one was a bald man, and one with a skin disease, abras, and one was blind. The angel came to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angel in a form of a human being to communicate with him. And he came to him. He said, what you like the best out of this dunya? What do you want? He said, well, what I want, some hair on my head. So because this means that people shine away from me, nobody wants to sit with me. I'm a bald-headed person. I need this. It caused me trouble in my life. So he said, what is the best property you like to have? He said, camels. The angel, by the will of Allah, wipe him, pass his hand on his head, touch him, and by the will of Allah, the man became with a hair in the best fashion. And he gave him a pregnant camel, a she camel, and say, may Allah bless it for you. And this camel gives camels and camels and camels, and became a valleys of camels. He became rich man, he became millionaire, and also he became handsome, looking good. And after this, the angel gone about his way. And he went to the second person, the person who has the skin disease, abras. He said, what you like? Wish. said, I wish that I be given, replaced with a better skin, with a nice color, because it made the people shining away from me. Nobody want to associate with me or sit with me. He said, what kind of property is the best for you? He said, cows. So by the will of Allah, the angel touched him. And the man has no illness or sickness or disease on his skin anymore. He looked handsome and good. And he gave him a cow, a pregnant one, and say, may Allah bless it for you. Allah bless it and give cows and cows and cows, valleys and valleys of cows he have. He became a millionaire or billionaire. And the angel kept going. He went to the blind man. He said, what do you like? He said, I wish that I can see. I need my vision so I can see the people. I hear people talking, but I could not see what they look like. Let's stop here for a second. Did you ever think about your vision? Did you ever think about your eyes? Did you ever think about your skin? Did you ever think about your color? Did you ever appreciate the hair that Allah gave you? Many things that didn't pay nothing for it. And you take advantage of it because you're born with it. And you have it right and left. So the angel asked him, the blind man, what the best property you like to have? He said, I like sheep. He gave him a sheep and said, may Allah bless it for you. Now the man have a lot of sheep, and was not one mazra'a or one field, but became valleys full with sheep, became so rich. The angel done about his business. Later on he came, disguising himself by the will of Allah, and he came in the same shape and the same form as the bold man used to be, and say, I'm a poor man, well traveler. I'm a person who's homeless. I have no way to go to finish my journey, my trip. I have no means to reach to my goal other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then after this is you. You're the only one can help me after Allah. He say, I have a lot of bills. I have to pay this and that. A lot of debts, a lot of credit, He say, I think I recognize you. The angel said to him, I think I know you. Do you used to be a poor man? Do you used to be a bold man? He said, I inherit this money from my father, from grandfather, ancestor, been rich millionaire people, royal family all our life. What are you talking about? He said, if you are a liar, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you go back in the state that you used to be. All what he asked him, for one camel, it can be a means of transportation before he die from the traveling. He's a poor man. All what I need, 1%, one camel. You have all these valleys. But right away, I have a lot of bills, he gone. He went to the second man. The man with the skin disease, or used to be with the skin disease, leprous. He said, a poor man, I have no means to finish my journey other than Allah, then you. And this is always that we have to learn how to single Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything. So Allah, then the people. Not Allah and the people. Not Allahu ant, but Allah, then the people. He said, I have no means to finish my journey and about to die. Would you give me one cow? It can be a means of food for me, and I can ride and put my luggage on it so I can reach to my destination. He gave him the same answer. He said, I think I recognize you. Do you used to be a person, look like me, with a skin disease? And you used to be a poor, you have nothing, sin. I have this money all my life. I inherited from my father, from grandfather, with the royal family, with the people of oil, with the people that were born from Mars or from other planet. No, what are you talking about? He said, if you are a liar, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala return you back to your state that you used to be. And it's been done. The angel continued his journey and he go in a form of a man blind to the man that used to be blind. He say, poor man, I have no way to finish my journey, my trip, other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you. Help me with one sheep, that it can be a means of food and transportation for me, at least to assist me to reach my destination. He say, listen, look to the valley. Take anything you want, any quantity you want. Wallahi, by Allah, I'm never going to even ask you how much you took, how much you left. Guess what? I used to be blind like you. I used to be a poor man like you. I used to have nothing like you. But Allah blessed me and gave me. He said, hold your property. Keep your property for you. Indeed, this was a test for three of you. Your two companions failed the test. You bear the test. May Allah bless your property. My dear respected brothers and sisters, and the khutbah is for me before you. You know what country he came from? Do you remember before when he came as a student to this country? Do you remember when he used to live in such project? Do you used to remember when you used to have a bike, not even a car, not a Jaguar, not a Speed? Do you remember? We need when we drive, my brothers and sisters, that sometimes we look to rear view mirror. Don't keep looking in front of you. It's good that you keep most of your vision in front of you, your vision, your future, your plan. But keep looking. Especially before you make a turn, before you make a statement, before you make an action. Look in the rear view mirror, see if there is any traffic coming, any car. It's very important. We remember our past, when we used to be non-Muslims, or when we used to be sinners, or when we used to be single, when we used to be unmarried, or when we used to be working for $4 and $5. We don't have a green car. We don't. Well, you know what is what? Look in the mirror. See what is going in the back. Don't forget, some of us used to wash dishes. Us as men or women in the same river that we drink from it. We used to have the cow, we'd feed the cow, take the cow to drink from the same tir'a, or from the same river, and we drinking from the same place. We came to America, and Allah gave us this and that. And now we don't look anymore in the rear view mirror. We don't see what we used to be. Today, my dear respected brothers and sisters, I would like you to help me, because a super imam without a super community could not fly. And super people with no super imams, they could not fly. I believe you are super, and I think I become super because I'm dealing with you. Today is this khutbah that I'm asking you kindly, that tonight before you go to sleep, take a piece of paper and pencil and do your homework. Let me give you a real story. We used to have about four brothers. I'm not going to say sisters, but I did not allow it to be to the best of my ability. When I saw a sister sleeping in a car, when I saw a sister in a shelter, when I saw all the things, I tried even to sacrifice my little space of office in my property or Adli publication property, not to see a female. Men are a little bit tough. So I did not allow it with women, but I allowed for brothers. Four brothers used to sleep outside. Two of them, the Muslims. And the third one took Shahada. And the third one was reading the Quran every day to learn about Islam. We accommodate them for maybe a whole month. at least if we are not giving them food, we're giving them a place to sleep at night. Some of the members of the community complain about it. Complain about we have homeless on the property. Even the shura, they discuss it in their meeting about homeless. Yes, they don't have a place to go. Not by the government, not by the church. They try different places. They have no other place. And this was the last stop that they come to the mosque for a shelter. At least they can go sleep in a winter or a cold weather. But some people, this was so disturbing for them. And one even said that my child was scared because he saw a homeless. What's the difference between a homeless, a normal, a human being? I don't understand. But guess what? Do you know among the Sahaba are the best people after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you know some of the Sahaba used to be homeless? Some of them even became homeless after they took Shahada and remained homeless after Islam, and they died homeless with one home, which is Jannah, insha'Allah. They were patient. And guess what? Their name used to be Ahl al-Suffa. I'm sure that most of you, if it's not all of you, heard about the name Ahl al-Suffa. They used to have something like a backyard or something for the mosque, and they used to sleep there. The jobless. And when somebody have a walima or nikah or whatever, some thread or some rice or whatever, they used to be given to them. Those people, some of them memorize Quran, some of them they narrated the hadith, but those Ahl al-Suffa. With a big demand or some demand that the problem have to be solved, that we could not have these people. Everybody have a bag of clothes or a suitcase, whatever it is. Some of them could not even find a place with the government shelters. And some of them, they got tired that before he eats the breakfast in the morning, you have to attend the prayer meeting. And they tell them about Jesus and the three and the one and all this nonsense. Okay? So, now we said, okay, what is the solution? Get rid of the homeless. So, a failure on me, because I was not wise enough to see what is the best solution. So today maybe we have 5, 6, 7 people in the shura, and I'm sure that we have 70 people sitting here, or 170 or 270, and with more heads, more complaints, I mean more ideas, no, excuse me, with more heads, okay, can be more confusion, and also can be a better result. And bringing the problem back to you as a community, not as a shura because we took it as a shura, not to some of the members because few people make the demand, and we remove them especially during Ramadan. But where they can go? What do you think is the best solution? Money? I know that some of you will say money. Do you know how much it will cost you to put at least 4 people in a place? $150 per week for one person. So do we have enough money? I'm only helping you with your homework. I'm giving you some hints so your homework will be easier in you. Please, I'm asking you, for the sake of Allah, be part of the solution. Don't be part of the problem, okay? We have enough, we have some problems, alhamdulillah. And all this is a test for everybody. But today we asking you in this khutbah, kindly that you send me an email to IslamicCenterOfColombia@yahoo.com, or write your homework and drop it in the charity box. So, because this homeless problem is for Muslims and non-Muslims, and part of a quiet and silent da'wah is to feed. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين. He doesn't encourage the feeding of the poor. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to his Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى، ووجدك عائلا فأغنى. فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر، وأما السائل فلا تنهر، وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. Yes, they are homeless. Yes, some of them they may be used to be criminals. Yes, maybe some of them, you understand, they used to be sleeping in the park and the police chasing them from here to here. We know all these things. Some people talk about safety and security. So why are you so worried about safety and security, and these people come to spend